Welcome to ECE 3300 at the University of Utah. In lecture number 16, we're going to talk about the Biot-Savart law. The Biot-Savart law is to the magnetic field, like Coulomb's law is to the electric field, and that's why we're going to study it right now together. The operations that we do, the calculations for the Biot-Savart law and Coulomb's law are very, very similar, and I'll be showing you what I mean. Let's consider kind of a grid of possibilities. Let's talk about the electric field up here on the top, and let's talk about the magnetic field down on the bottom. If we have an electric field distribution or a charge distribution that is just kind of random, maybe there are some point charges, maybe there are a few line charges, then we apply Coulomb's law. If we have a nice symmetric charge distribution, and perhaps we want to find the electric field out here, then we can apply Gauss's law for the electric field. You'll learn about Gauss's law later. Now remember I said that the Biot-Savart is to the magnetic field like Coulomb's law is to the electric field. So down here, if I have a random current distribution, maybe I have a combination of line currents, maybe I have a few point currents, maybe I have some surfaces, then I can use the Biot-Savart law. But if I have a nice, uniform, symmetric current distribution, then I can apply Faraday's law in order to find the magnetic field at a point out here. So Coulomb's law and Biot-Savart law can be used for random distributions of charges in the case of Coulomb's, current in the case of Biot-Savart. Gauss's law for the electric field and Faraday's law only apply when we have symmetric charges in the case of Gauss's law and currents in the case of Faraday's law. This is the Biot-Savart law. It says that the magnetic field here is equal to the current crossed with a vector divided by 4 pi times the vector squared. If we have a current going in this direction, I, so perhaps this is an IZ current, and we want to find the magnetic field right out here, we define a unit vector R, which is in the direction between our source and our field point, the magnitude of the distance between the source and the location of H is R. So I take my I and I cross it with this unit vector, and that gives me the top portion of the Biot-Savart. I find the distance between my source and my magnetic field, and that gives me the distance R squared. So in this lecture, we're going to learn how to use the Biot-Savart law to find H or B from a current distribution. Those are vectors. The current distributions could be line, surface, or volume in three different coordinate systems. So let's first consider the different types of current distributions I might have. If I had a simple current going in one direction, I, then I could use a line surface representation. I'm going to change my notation a little bit from the book because I want you to notice that the vector that's represented here is actually the direction that the current is going, not specifically the direction that the integration variables are going. So here's my current, and it's going in the z direction. If I want to find the magnetic field out here, I'm going to define my unit vector in the direction from my source to the location where I want to find the field. If I had something like a strip, a surface, I might have a surface current distribution, Js. Js would be given in amps per meter squared, and notice it does have a direction. A third possibility might be something like a cylinder, a volume of current, and that would be a Jv. Notice that the current, again, has a direction, and this is a volume current density given in amps per meter cubed. So these are the three different current distributions that I may use in Biot-Savart: line, surface, and volume. And we'll be looking at each one of those separately.